begin to run public relations as part of their daily, you know, projects. Every project that is run has a public relations component to it, a finance element. Am I correct? Yeah, you always have, you know, the treasurer is always there telling you how much money there is, tracking how much money, you know, we're spending, and making sure the reports are being done right. In the same way, when all clubs, anytime they have a project, anytime they have an initiative, if they start to look at public relations as one of the key elements, you know, at the end of the day, you will not need a public image coordinator like myself. And so I'm trying to work myself out of the job because that's the vision. I want the clubs, I want the district to be able to plan their own public relations at every given point. That's a step in the way. So, let's talk a little bit about public image. We can move to the next slide. Okay, so this is what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to start off with the role of public PR in the strategic plan. I'll give you a short presentation of that. We will then talk about the, we will then set PR committee goals. Okay, so together we are going to set PR committee goals. So that when we walk out of here, we know exactly what we want to achieve in our clubs. We know exactly what we want to achieve in our district. And then we will look at, I'll talk a little bit about social media. I'll talk about Rotary's brand revitalization project. And then finally, we'll wrap up for about 5 minutes. So, Charles, next slide, please. Good. So, these are our learning objectives. And I hope that when we walk out of here, with the sound, people tell me what I need to do so that we can stop getting the feedback.
No battery.
Somebody in sound, tell me what do I need to do so we can stop getting that feedback. I step back. Okay. Alright, thank you. So you're not just an MC, but you're also doing sound. That was a sound engineer. Okay. Good. We will look at, we want to have a clear understanding. Right, of the need for promoting a positive public image for our Rotary clubs. We'll develop a clear public image goals for our clubs, and then we will also discuss social networking tools. Right, how social networking tools can promote a positive public image. Okay, Charles, next slide please. You know, I asked President Pallion, he came to our district, and he was being interviewed by the one of the business daily, the biggest and most respected business newspaper in Kenya. And when he was asked about Rotary's image, this is what he said. He said, Rotary's image today is one of inclusivity, it's young, current generation, and connected. Do you agree? Do you agree? Well, you sound like you're a little skeptical. Yeah. You're skeptical, yeah? So why are you skeptical? Oh, you agree with the statement? Anyone doesn't agree with the statement? It's interesting. When I speak to, you know, to conferences about this, a lot of people say that, no, this is not Rotary's image. A lot of Rotarians say that. A lot of Rotarians say, oh, Rotary's image is one of old men like to have lunch and dinner together, you know? And then I say, well, you know, the thing is, the biggest hang-up with our public image is actually the Rotarians themselves. Do you don't agree? What do you think it is? So Rotary is of elitist and professional, elitist and professional group. So one of the things that I think comes across as well is the fact that we as Rotarians are hang up with our old image. Because when I look at the group here today, I see young people. I see people who are connected within the society. I see people who are able to get programs moving. Am I right? I see young people here. I see energetic people. I see the current generation. I see people who know how to get things going on the ground. Our image has changed. And I think the first thing that we have to do is change our mind about our image. Because you ask people about it and they'll say, yeah, we are old people. You know, it's old men. It looks like you have to have the white hair as, you know, to be eligible to join the Rotary Club. So our image has changed, and I think we need to be quite clear that our image is all about the young, the current generation, and it's a future generation. Okay, Charles. Okay, so, right, a lot of it has to do with the legacy. You know, there's a lot of misconceptions about Rotary, like I've talked about. The other thing that the other challenge that we're facing is, when I joined Rotary, I saw that Rotary was 1.2 million Rotarians in over 150 countries, you know, etc. 10 years later, how many Rotarians are we? We're still 1.2. Maybe the number of countries that's going up, but you know, now they say 200 countries, but it's still 1.2 million Rotarians. And apparently, in the last 10 years, there have been 1 million Rotarians joining, and the same number leaving. Can you imagine? So that's more than 50% of, that will almost be 100% growth if we manage to retain them. So we're having challenges with membership growth. In Africa, luckily we are seeing a positive membership growth, but when it comes to, but in other countries like the US and Japan, we are actually seeing reduced membership growth. So it's a big challenge for us. We are finding it harder to get project buy-in or partner project buy-in. We have a project that we run every year where we get disabled children we have a funding for disabled children around the Nairobi area. And we used to get fantastic sponsorship for this. It was all paid for by corporates. Today, we find it such a challenge to get corporates to finance it. And we're finding that most of it is being financed by Rotarians themselves. So, donor organizations that we partner with do not understand our organization. Then we're also seeing competition from other humanitarian service groups. You know, for example, the Lions. Yeah, are the Lions big in Nigeria? Yes? No? Sorry? Yes, a little. They're a little big. Okay. So, yes, we do see that there's those kind of organizations, the Giants, there's all these other organizations that are also looking for membership. And when I was doing interviews for the brand revitalization project, I was talking to DGs in Mauritius and asking them what the image of Rotary was and who the competition was. One of the DGs, in fact, my district governor, Peter Knight, she said that we're not just competing with other humanitarian organizations, we're competing for other things like the gym, we're competing for nightclubs, you know, we're competing with nightclubs, we're competing for people's time. And all the things that are happening in a modern day lifestyle are eating into people's time. And that's what we're competing against. And therefore, we need to be able to have something to offer, or at least present what we are offering in a way that will be appealing to the younger groups. Okay, and then we're talking about lack of differentiation. I mean, sometimes I say to people, I'm a Rotarian, and they say, is that the Lions? Boy, I had a friend who was a Lion, and it's like, oh, we're completely different. But to the public, to us, as we sit here as Rotary leaders, as Rotary Club members, we think there's differentiation. But to the public, there's actually very little differentiation. And those are some of the things that we need to do. Okay, so next slide, Tom. So within Rotary, the strategic plan, I remember when I was club president of my club in 2004, 2005, you know, that was the year that they said that it was mandatory for all clubs to have a public relations check within the club. And I think what's been happening before is Rotary has been more or less discreet. We have been quiet about what we were doing. We had members who wanted to keep their heads down, get the job done and not feel ashamed about it. Which is fine for the time, and we did grow from 4 members to 1.2 million members. Now, but then times have changed. People's lifestyles have changed. What people do has changed, and that's the reason why Rotary really has changed as well. And we needed to be able to tell our story, and tell our story accurately. Right, so it's the board of directors understood this, and this is why it's part of the strategic plan. We have three key pillars of the strategic plan. One is to strengthen clubs. Two is to enhance service projects, and three is to improve Rotary's public image. So every club needs to be looking at those key things. Right? Were you aware of this strategic plan? Were you aware of this strategic plan? Okay. Does your club have a strategic plan? Is PR or public image part of that strategic plan? Okay, good. Then the session's over. Is it really part of that strategic plan? How serious is it? Do you have a budget for your strategic for public relations? Do you have a budget for public relations in your club? Okay, I think now we're getting somewhere. So no, we don't have. So who has a budget? Okay, how much is it?
I just got that message today. And we've invited her to the meeting,
on Tuesday, next Tuesday, to come and see what Rotary is all about. You know, so having a proper public image will make people want to join. Right? They will be, what is Rotary all about? How can I join? In terms of getting funds, in terms of getting donor support, it helps that tremendously. Because when people know that we're doing good as a community, when people know that apparently, if you look at the Rotary overall, all the projects that we're doing, including the foundation and the local project, we're probably close to about $40 billion worth. Right? Close to $40 billion. And if people, donors understand that, they will want to help. They want to help with a large, effective organization such as Rotary. And so it's important for us to improve our community for those reasons. Other things is, we're now moving into the future grants. And RRFCs, the Rotary Foundation coordinators will be telling you that the future vision, and we'll be talking about that in this district conference, I believe it'll be happening tomorrow, and probably one of the breakout sessions. But we need to partner with the global grants, we need to partner with strong organizations that are doing good in the community as well. And I think one of those partnerships has been with the Agri-Khan Foundation. And we will continue to do this, obviously, as the future grants and future vision kicks in. So it's important for us to be able to build strong relationships with large organizations that are doing things at a global scale. And then it's important to recognize Rotary clubs and Rotary members, you know, who are doing a good job. You know, it just makes you feel good, you know, when you see Rotary is doing a good job across the world. So I remember one time I was flying to the US and I went through Brussels. And on the flight, I got this, there was this magazine, the Inside magazine. And as I was looking through the pages, I saw this close campaign. You know, one of the West African celebrities, you know, showing this post. And I was so excited, I actually jumped out of my seat. You know, and I wanted to show everybody that, hey, look, Rotary is in the magazine. And, you know, we feel a sense of pride. And I think that sense of pride is important for us to move forward. Okay, all right. So, talking about, so priorities for clubs and districts. Now this is a simple 4-point plan, you know, that I developed over the years, having looked at, you know, some of the key things that we need to do. So I noticed that whenever we go out and we do training, for example, today's training, if you don't have, those without an idea, those without a background in public relations, advertising, and the rest, will find it very difficult to implement some of the key strategies that come out of these trainings. But those people who have experience, those people who have qualification, those people who have worked in the industry will find it easy, they will build on the ideas, and they will implement them in clubs. Right? So, I think number one is we need to identify and build close relationships with influential champions. Right? In many cases, you know, I get the press release is sent over to me. Club is saying we are opening up a water project. You know, we'd like to invite the media. Can you invite as many media houses as possible? And they send me a press release. And what we're doing in most cases is we're sending a lot of emails to very many people, right? And we're sending a lot of information to very many people. And they have no, other than the email, they don't have much of an idea of what Rotary is all about. And if they don't know what Rotary is all about, most of the time, those invitations are going to end up in the bin. Right? They're going to end up in the trash can. Most of the time, the journalists will, if the journalist knows where you're coming from, they understand the organization and they know you, there's a much better chance of getting your story published. Right? Getting your story published and enhancing the public image. So it's important for us to start to build close relationship with influential journalists. It doesn't have to be with 100 journalists. You know, if in your club you have one journalist, or you develop a relationship with an influential journalist, one, just at least one, that will mean that you'll get much better quality stories from that publication. Do you agree? Yeah? So this is something that we need to do. Let's ensure that we start to work on those relationships. And those relationships we're talking about having lunch together, buying drinks, you know, and just being able to communicate, build up a personal relationship with them. It actually calls for that. Number two, let's begin to identify people who work in the public relations industry as and invite them to be members. So, work journalists, people who work in advertising, people who work in public relations, you know, PR officers. Let's get them into our clubs. So, this year alone, I have invited three people who work in the industry into my club. The first one was a journalist who works with the leading management magazine in the country. The second one is a video producer. She's a managing director of a video production outfit. And the third one is a marketer with our largest media house, with 70 radio stations and one TV station. So, and they always have great ideas of what we can do. As we were trying to figure out what to do with our district conference PR, you know, this is a new member, she only joined last week, and she had lots of ideas. She says, why don't you write a message, an email to our marketing manager, and he will be able to sort out all these things. So we managed to get interviews in five different radio stations over the week of the district conference, and our presidents were giving these interviews during the breakfast session. You know, just because she is a member of our club. You see how it works? Okay, good. Then we need to have substantial PR training. We talked about training. So have you all promised to have training in your clubs for public relations? Okay, good. Excellent. And then finally, we need to use social media. We need to use social media. I think social media seems to be working tremendously in terms of gaining club members. And DG Yang had told me that the Rotary Club of Fort Harcourt, they had seven new members based on through social media. Is that true? Absolutely. Social media, but a round of applause. Social media is very powerful. Social media tends to be very cheap as well. Okay, good. So let's move on to the next slide. Talk very briefly about the PR brand. Actually, to tell you what I want to be the update. The real update is that all three districts in Nigeria are part of a seven district joint PR brand this year for the next year. Right? So seven districts, for the first time, seven districts in Africa have come together for a public relations brand. And this public relations brand is going to go towards membership. To go towards improving membership, because we have committed, we as district governors have committed to raising the number of Rotarians by 10,000 to the next 2 years. 10,000 new Rotarians in Africa in the next 2 years. Did you know that? You know that? All of you? Okay, well, now you know you have a lot of work to do. Yeah, you have a lot of work to do. You have to bring members into the club. But anyway, because of that, we have put in the public relations grants together, and we're looking at membership. So that's one of the key things I want to put. Lots and lots of resources by Rotary. So print ads, they have video ads, radio ads, they have humanity in emotion ads. And all you have to do is search on the website, and you'll be able to download high quality, high resolution pictures, high quality videos, high quality audio files, which you can then be able to adapt and then play back in your own media. So if somebody ever asks you, somebody from the media house says, do you have creative material that I can use? They'll normally say, do you have high quality creative material that you can use? Say yes, and all you have to do is search the Rotary website and you'll be able to find what you're looking for. All you may have to do is adapt it so that you have a local telephone number or a local club's website that people can go to. Right? So this, as you can see, what we have here is we have the This Close campaign, you know, with various people. There's, I think, over 35 stars now who are in the This Close campaign. And this close campaign is important to let people know what Rotary is doing in Poli. And they use people who the communities or local communities can identify. Yeah. So I know Poli Nigeria is also part of the soccer player, the soccer star. He's also in this. And we also have Kalia Banerjee, our own brave Kalia Banerjee. If you just go to the next slide, Charles. Yeah, our own very own Kalia Banerjee for us, you know, and so we can actually connect. Good. So, very quickly, I'll give you a couple of success stories. And this is just for ideas, you know, to just be able to share the good stuff that we've done across Africa. In East Africa, we now have a tradition where we have a corporate breakfast. So every year, we have a breakfast that is organized by Rotarian and business leaders. And what we do is we talk about the Rotary project, help them understand what Rotary is all about, what we're currently doing, and give them an opportunity to participate. Right? So this happens in, it's happened in Uganda, it's happened in Kenya, and we'll be doing it again in the next Rotary year. It's a great way of building close relationships with the business community and then also getting some publicity. In Egypt, they carried out a project where they gave £50 to poor families, giving them a livelihood, not just food, but also a livelihood because they were able to sell the extra milk and make an income from them. When they went back to the community, they found that these communities, the cows were still there and the communities were actually we got excellent publicity from that, and we got publicity when we donated the cows, and we got publicity when we went back to see how the cows were doing. So that was really, really good, good PR in Egypt. In South Africa, during the World Cup in Cape Town, we were able to brand the airport with a disclosure campaign, so that all the people that went down to Cape Town to watch the matches there. And the, you know, the tourism that was happening around there got fantastic publicity about what we're doing with polio. And in Benin, when we had the World Polio Day, Boris Pestia was able to organize a media kit. Throughout the week, there was stories about polio every day in the newspapers and radio and television. It was excellent. And in South Africa, when we had Ray's Rotary reunion 2 years ago, they used the matching grants to brand two taxis and then drive across Cape Town, all over Cape Town. And we were able to get Rotary's message through those taxis driving all over the place. So those are a couple of ideas of what people can do with your budgets, your public relations budgets to be able to gain publicity. And then of course this, what you just saw on the screen, sorry, just go back one more time. What you saw on the screen there, this is that ad that I saw when I was in Brussels. You know, that I jumped out of my seat and I'm telling everybody that look, Rotary is in the magazine. Okay, good. So yes, looking at goal setting, which is what I want us to be doing now in this session, some of the things that we have to think about are what are the challenges that we are facing as Rotarians? What are the challenges that our class challenges that our public space. And when you identify what those challenges are, you can then be able to develop strong, priorities to improve or to be able to run really good population projects. So what I want us to do now, actually just to move on to the next session, is I'd like us to spend a bit of time talking about the priorities PR committee. Okay, so I'm going to ask questions, and perhaps what I could do is, can I get a young volunteer, somebody who can type very quickly? Anybody who can type very quickly? Prepare the beautiful. Ah, good, we've got one. Right, okay. So if you one of the presentations is open, yes. Yeah. Just one of the presentations is open on the computer. You will see there's some blank slides. So you just need to write down what people say. All right, so now I've talked enough. I want you guys to go. Is that fair? Okay, good. So what would you say let's start with the rules. What are the rules of the club committee? We have a roving mic.
Sorry, the attention of your good community. Problems with the community. I appreciate what you can do about it.
So, creating awareness of issues in the community.
Publicize the project being done by Rotary.
Okay, publicize the project. Alright, I think we've got two hands down here. There's a gentleman, a lady. This, I think it's part of being able to promote Rotary's programs. Right? Being able to promote Rotary's programs that are priority in the most community.
In my opinion, the current committee has to prepare an estimate of budget for the year on PR and present it to the board of directors. And the deliberation and approval.
Very, very important. If we're talking about making sure there's budget, the PR committee will prepare that budget and ensure that the budget is properly utilized. Okay, we'll take one more.
I believe that in all these roles, certain tools are required to ensure that they are properly made available for the success of those who want to attain. And it is the PR committee's responsibility to develop those tools, avenues, or instruments by which all these that have been enumerated will be achieved. It could be through social media, through prints or electronic media, or whatever, through the town hall meetings and all that. If you don't provide it, the grammar may not be properly applied.
Okay. Good. So, develop PR tools. And I'll also say utilize the RI developed tools. Okay, good. So, are we clear on some of the key things that we need to do as a public relations committee? Do we know? Yeah? Are you happy with what we have? Okay. Sorry? Yes, I think that's a good point. I think what we're talking about here, without going into too much detail, is that this is much more about creating awareness of Rotary's programs. Yeah, that's where public relations comes in. So if you just take out that point, and we'll consider it under creating awareness of Rotary's programs. Okay, are you happy with that now? Okay, super. Great. Now, I think what we need to do now is look at, I think you can take out that, just take out that line altogether. Just take out the line altogether. We're going to keep it under creating awareness of Rotary's programs. Take out that line, it's part of Rotary's programs and the Public Relations Committee can provide awareness. The key priorities in that region. Okay, good. Now, let's look at a couple of key goals for the clubs. So if we go on this slide number 4, we can then begin to list down the goals of the PR committee. So, I can preempt this or I can prompt this. So there is a bit of conflict in various parts of Nigeria, there is a bit of conflict. Is that? Okay. Let me go back. Let me take a step back. There is, what's Rotary's image at the moment? How is Rotary's image at the moment? It's a Western organization, right? An American organization, right? It is, they look at it with skepticism. Right? Okay? So, now, for the clubs in the north, for example, considering that is one of the key, that is one of the key challenges, what can the club do to improve the perception of rugby? Can anybody attempt to answer that? Okay, we've got two hands here.
I think the major issue there is the courage of the individual, because like in the journalism profession, a good photograph can tell the story, 1,000 words cannot tell. So it depends on the way the individual members of the club carry themselves in society. Tells a lot of stories.
Okay. All right. So the individual members, okay, will hold us back, of course. Lady in red.
Thank you.
Something different, but
believe in hands-on projects. You could get the contractor to go and paint a building, provide water, get levels to clean up an environment by way of sanitation or environmental concern. But if you are not there, the community does not see you getting involved. It does not make as much impact. I would rather encourage Rotarians that sometimes
service above self, which Rotary stands for.
made me join Rotary. There are not many, clergymen here in Rotary. Even when we go in international mission, first it's always on me. Why are you in Rotary? I'm in Rotary because the motive is right. It's in corollary with what the religions of the world stand for. Service and God's self. And there's no other way you can propagate that and make people to buy it and be a Rotary or associate with Rotary, except when we are having happenings like this, induction services and other happenings, we invite non-Rotarians to come. And the moment they get the right, that we have the right motive, that will bring peace and prosperity in the nation, they will join. It took me 7 good years to get this motive right before I was able to have the courage to join Rotary as an archdeacon of the Anglican community. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I think I think one of the things, if we're looking at, public relations for gaining membership, one of the things that we can do as a party is to ensure that we have at least one membership cocktail in a year, so we can invite non-Rotarians to understand what we do, and ensure that the Public Relations Committee or Public Relations is involved in that. Perhaps we get it publicized in the media and that kind of thing. Okay? All right, good. No, I think it's not over. Okay? All right, so. Okay. Who's finished? 5 minutes is up? No, he didn't speak. Okay. All right, okay, good. Good talk.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon, fellow Rotarians. Very positively to attract membership. It has intrinsic value. Brand is simply an identity. It's the sum total of all the experiences of what we do. Brand is also much more than a logo. So you have to build your brand, right? Build your brand. That's what Joe was about to say. Brand shapes perception. Brand drives international giving. Brand attracts strategic partnership. Brand creates value. And brand drives membership, which is the real goal of this public meeting. We all know that Rotary has been shy, or Rotary International has been shy about publicity. So that's why we need for brand revitalization. Now the challenge we all have is that do people really know us? Do people really know who we are? That's the number one challenge. And the second challenge, do people really know what we do? Can anybody answer, do people really know us? Do people really know what we do? And what does Rotary does not stand for? That's the challenge, and we have to address these challenges. Now, what is our responsibility? Somebody that part of the world said, service above self. I think we should remind ourselves that Rotary International is a world of Nigeria focused on one. And what is the one goal? What is the one goal? Exactly. So we should engage in PR activity. As we are concerned, structural communication, internal and external, in our organization. And the major focus will be on people, the processes we adopt, the physical evidences, and resources. I'm summarizing, I'm trying to wrap up, sorry, because we don't have a long time. Then, another part of our responsibility is that we should be hungry for change. And in this district, what do you call yourself? Game changers. So we should be hungry for change. And the fundamentals of what our responsibilities is the action plan. Joe has said it, we should set clear objectives, that is, we should set goals, which we have been talking about. We should define our target audience. And then there's always a timeline, either long-term or short-term. But if you have a timeline, short term should build up to a long term program. Develop key messages for the rest. Now the media should do some media relations and publicity. Now he talked about it. You understand, prune and cut the media. You should love the media. You should embrace them. You know, you can have a media day. And I think the district governor has been, our e-governor has been doing something wonderful. We talk a lot, you know, and he's been doing a lot of wonderful things with the media. The rare people synergy for your club and voting in your community. That's what you were saying earlier. And how do we do that? Advertise yourself. Let your community know you. Let your community understand you. And let the poor waiters show you.
Hello.
Am I communicating? Then again, these are all the fundamentals, what we have to do, which I think Joe had taken in the last session. You do good. You have to be transparent, you have to be sincere and genuine. These are the key principles of a media plan. You have to do good to the media. Not necessarily brown envelope and so on, but you have to do good to them. Be transparent, be sincere, be genuine to them. Learn to say thank you so that you can get more. Try to say thank you to the media and you can get more. And as leaders in Rotary, you should have a team spirit. Have a team spirit as a team. Know who is responsible for each implementation of the steps in the action plan. Then resources, we have talked about resources. But we are in our inner setting goals. We have human resources, we have informational resources, and we have financial resources. So, well, finally, we exploit many other actions. We have talked about social media network, Facebook, Twitter, blog, and please use this network positively. The philosophy of this PR process is think locally and act locally. Why? Because the public image starts with you. Thank you. So let us put all these awards into action. Create more awareness, take action, share Rotary, make Rotary a bigger, better, and bolder brand. And which we need to embrace humanity. Because the future of Rotary is in your hands. Thank you.